We started doing these curved crease forms, and they helped us interpret what they might be doing mathematically. And then the reception from people was, wow, you should do more of these. And that grew into sculpture. The very first printed one that we did was based on a short story called The Destructors.
It's by Graham Greene. And the theme of the story is that destruction is a form of creation. We took that as kind of permission to take this short story and destroy it by mashing it up onto a big piece of paper and then folding it into a sculpture. The text is still on the sculpture, but to read it, you would have to destroy the sculpture again, like unfold it.
I think what makes this collaboration so exciting is we surprise each other all the time with new ideas that are unexpected.
Yeah, it goes back and forth seamlessly between us, and by the end, we forget who came up with what idea. For Beethoven's 250th anniversary, we printed some pages of his hand-drawn score from one of his last works, which is Große Fuge, or Gross Fugue, put it onto the paper that we folded.
It was done for Beethoven's house in Bonn, Germany. We played the music while we worked on the piece, and that had a dramatic effect on how the piece came together.
I think we're always looking for the surprising, because, you know, it's more exciting if you find a mathematical result that no one expected would be true, or if you make a sculpture that no one expected you would ever make.
There's the Braille sculpture that was done for a museum in Denmark for visually challenged people. The Braille is in Danish.
Normal Braille books are read in straight lines. So we had to invent new processes just for embossing Braille to get it in a weird spiral shape.
There's a book art show we got invited to, and there has been the biggest book and the smallest book, but no one has ever done the longest book.
We were starting to play around with taking an existing book like Pride and Prejudice, but the whole book is in this giant roll of paper.
There will be fold lines printed on the roll of paper. Will this give us measurements of the strip? Because that's kind of important as well.
Sort of, yeah. That's going to be 1,500 feet.
1,500 feet, that's...
It's only a quarter mile.
Oh yeah, that's not bad.
That's for chapter one.
Whoa.
That's definitely
all right, so
not
you're
going
to have to do some tweaking.
Because we do paper folding and glass blowing, we're always looking for different ways to combine paper and glass, two mediums that don't really want to work well together because glass is super hot and paper burns. So the first series of combining these materials is the like paper inside a glass vessel. But more recently, we've been experimenting with burning paper in a controlled environment. So we take hot glass right out of the furnace and then pour the glass over the paper.
It's on wet paper, so it chars. It doesn't generally burn through.
It likes to wiggle around and make sort of uncontrolled fine motion, but then at the macro scale, you can control where it goes. And so you're essentially drawing with hot glass. We call the resulting designs pyroprints. And those are a little bit fragile to fold because we did burn like partway through the paper. So usually we photograph those and print them onto fresh paper and then fold that into one of our curved crease sculptures. And then if we want, put it in glass. So then it kind of closes the loop of we start with glass, burning paper, we fold the paper and put it back into glass.
We're done? No, we're not done.
Until the next thing.